Passengers, please take some time to read the safety information displayed throughout the train. And be aware that smoking or vaping is not allowed anywhere on this train.
So, as you kind of guessed, I'm in Castleford, and as you kind of guess, I visit Yorkshire Craft Beers. 10 beers, about 65 quid, £65 from the Pistol Series. From Seven Island Brewery, to Zulki. From Pipeline Brewing, Cornwall, the New York Dreams Oat Cream IPA, from Brew York, the John Biscotti, the king of Brew York Biscotti Imperial Pastry. Everyone seems to be doing pastry stouts at the moment. Buying them from Pastel Brewing and designed by Committee Double IPA. I had two lovely double IPAs yesterday, one from Stagmarilli and one from New Bristol Brewery. Originally at Wigan, this is Twisted Wheel Brew and the Space Hopper New England IPA. Where is this based out now? Warrington. From Overtone Brewing, this is their Dusty Miller Stout, 11%, and they're based out of Glasgow. Just making sure my train. When I was supposed to click last time that I wanted, but I ended up buying all the stouts. Finally got it. This is the North Ruin and Track collaboration. The IPA. Another double IPA from Little Monster Brewing Company and Dank Dad Collective. That's their squash court. And they're based out of East Grinstead, wherever that is. I purchased this because it looked pretty awesome. Last silver can I bought was what's it called now? Gives a U. And they were based out of down south, but this one's based out of Sheffield. It's the Aberdale. It was a Stoutzilla beer. Up somewhere. And strawberry tigers and rooftop jacuzzis, strawberry chocolate smoked cherry, wood chipped imperial dessert stout. And finally, I saw this on my emails the other day, Novel Monk collaboration with Tom Joy, and it's the Imperial Coffee and Plum Stout. But yeah, 10 beers, 10. Lovely sounding beers. The selection in Yorkshire Craft Beers was very good. Definitely recommend either trying their website or if you live local, check them out. Now we'll get my train. So, my train is in like 10 minutes time, 5-10 minutes time, between that time. So I do have two beers to try. Both look like BrewDog beers. We've got the low profile, which looks like the BrewDog IPA, Punk IPA, on Punk AF, look how comfortable. And I've got the lowdown, which looks like BrewDog's managed it. This is the IPL, the Indie Pale Lager. I'm on the train, I can get sit and relax and enjoy these on the way to Leeds. But yeah, until then, masks up.
Mouth on board trains and at stations at all times, unless you are exempt.
Hello! So, first up is the IPL. Low alcohol, 0.5%. Usual dietary things, doesn't give much taste notes. Water feeder, mix a couple of those shavings in. and soda. And soda. Ooh, nice marine. Seems to be marine and also a refinery now.
We will shortly be arriving at Woodford.
I'm going to have to try Woodford a little bit.
If you are leaving the train, mind the gap between the train and platform edge.
Right. So, I got back from Castleford and then I went to do some chores and visited parents, did some for them, and then I went for a time. So, but anyway, so this were two non-alcoholic beers are from Omnipollo. They're two variations of Soppa. Yeah, so it's a pale ale brewed with blueberries and vanilla. This is the Blåbärs Soppa. Purchased these by a Triangle in Shipley. And the other variation is the Nyponsoppa, which is pale ale brewed with rosehip. They both weigh in at 0.3%. I saw these on the website and I thought, good try. Some different variations of a non-alcoholic beer, but by a well respected drinks company, Omnipollo. So this is the Nyponsoppa. See, that looks very similar. Yeah. This one, I think it's just different colours, because they basically look exactly the same. This one's brown and not red, the one's green, red. Okay. Off-white tanned head, minimal stick. Now I chose my nomadic glass because they're really good for pale ales. Nomadic making really good pale ales. But yeah. It has like a tanned orange head. Anyway, cheers. Fuck. I just woke up and the first thing I smell is this. It's very potent. I don't know how to describe it. It's very tart on the aroma. It's not a very pleasant smell. But anyway. The Nyponsoppa rosehip. Cheers. Tart. The smell there. It's almost like a little green tea. but it's very potent. Is it rosehip? I don't know if I like it. It's very different. Oh, I've just popped the can. I'll show you in a minute. Now this is a very different colour. This kind of looks like blood. It's a very, that's not doing that so good, but it's like a really vibe beetroot. It looks like beetroot. Let's see it. It looks like beetroot. That's a very unique color. It's not as bad, but it does smell like Earl Grey tea. This one was very potent. This is a little bit more less potent, but I don't even see it. It's a really vibrant kind of purple. I don't know. It kind of looks like beetroot. I think that's what it smells like. It's kind of like a vegetable kind of smell. Both of them are. And it's just, this one isn't as bad. The blueberries and vanilla mask it really well. It's actually quite palatable. It just looks like I'm drinking beetroot or red cabbage. Or do you call it purple cabbage? I don't know. But just, they're very unique. Anyway. Pale ale. They're both really nice representations of pale ale. But they're very, just like Omnipollo themselves. That as the drinks company that they are, they do push the limits of what they do. And yeah, it just says non-alcoholic beer. Would I buy these again? No. I just bought them because I wanted to experience Omnipollo brought to the non-alcoholic table. And they are very potent in flavour and aroma and appearance. But for me, it has to have a repeat, and it doesn't. It's just basically, it doesn't. But anyway, the normal beers I've had today, it's nice to try new normal beers, but keep on trying, and hopefully I'll find something I like. You take care. Goodbye. Hi, so I just quickly ran inside and did the Blåbärssoppa means blueberry soup. Nyponsoppa means hibiscus soup, and they both definitely were soup because they're very thick in texture. But I remembered I had one more alcoholic beer left from ALDI. This is Saint Etienne. I think Jake, maybe. I did review this. It's sunsetting now, so brewed for premium flavour, premium lager beer, 0%, 0% alcohol free. Saint Etienne. Dietary thing on the back. Oh, it's France, from France. But yeah, I was good inside. I thought, sit back and relax, enjoy these two soup non-alcoholic pale ales, one hibiscus, one blueberries. Yeah, oh, so tired. Even though I just woke up from a nap. Anyway, yes, and it's him. Lovely beer. More flavors in the IPA. More flavors in the IPA, both from Foundry, which I can't find anywhere on the internet, so I don't know who brews via Op Founder. Not as flavoursome as the two from Omnipollo, but they're like insane mental beers. But as a representation of an Marco Lager, very nice. Check it out in ALDI. Probably the one I'd probably buy again if I want to buy it again. But yeah, you take care. Goodbye. Just a quick add. The more sip on both the Omnipollos, they'll get more palatable. The initial palate is softened and just like whiskey. You start to enjoy it. But yeah. I mean, look at that. So initial reaction was kind of strange. I moved past that. And the more I drink, the more palatable they are, the more enjoyable. So second thoughts, I would buy them again.